Give the Lord a big hand of praise, and you may please be seated. Whatever name Adam called the animals, that was the name by which God called them. This service has been called Showers of Blessing in Service. And in the name of Jesus Christ, the blessings of the Lord that makes rich, that multiplies people, that changes people's stories without sorrows is coming on your life today. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Engaging the turnaround power of praise has been focused in our Sunday services. Engaging the turnaround power of praise. And our running text has been Habakkuk chapter 3, 17 to 19. Although the fig tree shall not blossom, there may not be fruits in the vine, the fruit of the olive may fail. He said, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. And the Lord will become my strength. He will make my feet like hinds' feet, and will get me up upon my high places. As I rejoice, He changes my stories. Everyone's story is changing from level to level before this month is over. That looks like you. Let me hear your loudest amen. God is not only able to save, He's able to save to the uttermost. That my daughter is a student of Landmark University, and it was on IT here in Lagos when she was captured by agents of the devil. But we know that God has given us power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and that nothing shall by enemies hurt us. Now I therefore decree today, anyone marked out for assault by the devil, the arrows of divine judgment hit them where they are now. And except the Lord has not sent me, everyone connected to that, my daughter's arrest and capture, will not see tomorrow morning. I release a prophetic curse on them, and in the name of Jesus, their own lives are declared terminated. In Jesus' name. You know, it is cheaper to destroy than to build. That's why we must be careful with prophets. It's cheaper to destroy than to build. It may take you a year to put up a building. It doesn't take 1 hour to bring it down. Just a liter of petrol will bring it down. God does not only bless, He clears anything that's resisting the blessing. He said, I will bless him that blesses you, and him that curses you, I will curse. So anyone that may want to stand the way of your blessings this morning comes under a curse. Every force that may want to stand the way of your blessings today, whether they be witches or wizards or occult powers, they are declared cursed in the name of Jesus. God the Father curses in His holiness. God the Son curses in His righteousness. And it not only curses, He also taught us to curse. They said to Him, the fig tree which thou cursest is withered away. He said, have the faith of God. If you say to this man, if you curse this mountain, get out of my way, it will go. So Jesus taught us to curse. Whatever is standing your way and resisting your advancement, Jesus said, is entitled to a curse. You know, it is God the Father who said, and I will curse him, I will bless him that blesses you, and him that curses you, I, the Almighty, the thrice holy God, will curse. So God the Father, in his entire holiness, curses. He curses oppositions, he curses resistances. So today, as the blessing of the Lord begin to come down, every force resisting the impact of these blessings on your life and your family and your career and your business and your children, come under a curse today. Somebody believe that, let me hear your loudest amen. He said, you must go and kill Bishop Oyedepo first, then come to me. He said, what? Bring your curse, my friend. That demon came out and used the cutlass on the leg that we not cut. Now hear me. Isaiah 65 and verse 8. Destroy it not, for there's a blessing in it. Now, by the blessings of the Lord today, you are declared indestructible. Now listen to this. Divine blessings makes men indestructible. Destroy him not, because there's a blessing in it. There's a blessing. Destroy. Destroy it not, for a blessing is in it. They couldn't destroy Joseph. Why? There was a blessing in him. He prevailed by the blessings of his father. They said, let's kill him. It was concluded to kill him. And that said, will he escape? So they said he committed rape of an army officer's wife. As a domestic staff, you are dead. But there's a blessing in him. He was not even beaten. There's a blessing in him. By the blessing of today, no matter the manipulations of the wicked one, you and your household are declared indestructible. I have not come to proclaim a blessing, but to implant a blessing. To implant a blessing. Destroy him not, because there's a blessing in it. Not a blessing on him. A blessing in him. But you see, the blessings of God, they are confirmed declarations of prophets. Isaiah 44 and verse 26, the word said, I am the Lord that confirmeth the words of his servant and performeth the counsels of his messenger, that say unto Jerusalem, thou shalt be inhabited, and to the cities of Judah, you shall be built, and I will raise up the decayed places thereof. When his servants speak forth, God is committed in his integrity to confirm it. Therefore, whatever looks like decaying around your life, as the prophetic word of blessing comes, I decree restoration of glory and honor. Everything that appears taken in your life is converted to shining entities. Destroy it not, for there's a blessing in it. How many are prepared for the implanted blessing? Implanted blessing. Not just blessing that people say to you, but blessings implanted into your lives. After Elisha returned from the double portion encounter, here were these 42 children mocking him. And he turned back and cursed them in the name of the Lord. And two bears came out of the woods and destroyed 42 children. Children were not spared for mocking the anointed. Therefore, whatever one says, what winner are you? Nonsense winner. Everything that is out to mock your work with God comes under a curse today in the name of the Lord. Everything that is mocking your redemption comes under a curse today in the name of the Lord. Somebody believe that, let me hear your loudest amen. We discover from scriptures that praise is a spiritual platform for fearful blessings. Let the people praise thee, O God, let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase, and God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him. Praise is a spiritual platform for fearful blessings. Having been involved and engaged in praising God, in dancing, in the night, in the day, in celebrating God, it is your turn for an encounter with fearful blessings. The blessing that will make your mockers fear. The blessing that will make your enemies fear. In the name of Jesus Christ. The reason is, when we are blessing God, when we are praising God, we are blessing Him. Psalm 34 verse 1. I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall be continually in my mouth. Every time you are praising God, what are you doing? You are blessing Him. And whatever good thing any man does, the same he shall receive from the Lord. So when you are blessing Him, you are provoking His blessings on your life. Praise is a spiritual way of humans blessing God. And when you bless Him, because the Bible says, whatever good thing any man does, the same he shall receive. Draw nigh unto me, I will draw nigh unto you. Bless me, and I will bless you. Bless me, and I will bless you. So when we are praising Him, we are blessing Him. And by blessing Him, we are provoking His blessings on our lives. This is so important. We are not entertaining God. No, we are blessing God. And as we bless Him in praise, He blesses us back in return. Today is a day of your returns and blessings. Psalm 103 verse 1 to 2. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. You're just blessing the Lord. You are blessing the Lord, and that entitles you to His blessings in return. So today is declared your day of returns and blessings. In Psalm 104, the same word is repeated in verse 1. It said, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, thou art very great. Thou art clothed with honor and majesty. Verse 2. Who covereth thyself with light as with a garment? Who stretcheth out the heavens as a curtain? Just celebrating His majesty is blessing Him. And as you bless Him, then you are entitled to His blessing. So if you want to be blessed, what do? Keep blessing God. Keep blessing Him. Yesterday we had 24 marriages here. Amen. Are you excited about that? Every time God speaks, everything hears. So all the forces that may be responsible for holding down your portion, any part of your portion of the double portion, next level's agenda, must give way today. By these blessings, you are prevailing over all your circumstances. When we bless Him, we commit His integrity to bless us back in return. After that hot and wide praise that David heard, as recorded in 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 14, he danced with all his might. The Bible says he returned to bless his household. And David, being a prophet, Acts chapter 2 verse 30, must have obeyed divine instruction. He returned back home to bless his household. This David has returned today, having put us on the line of high praises since the man began, to bless this household. And these blessings will stick on your life. Someone believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. These blessings will stick on your life. Nothing enhances destiny like blessings. I won't let you go until you bless me. He said, okay, what's your name? And change his name from a person to a nation. By the power, the turnaround power of blessing. What's thy name? He said, Jacob. He said, your name shall no longer be Jacob. Blessing has changed your name. But your name shall be called Israel. For as a prince, thou hast power with God and with man, and has prevailed. Genesis 32 and verse 28. So the blessings change its level from a person to a nation. Come on now. There are people here today, you came in as one. You are returning 1,000 times. Some are returning 10,000 times more. Some persons came here today by the blessings of the prophet. You are returning back home as a nation. Someone believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. You believe you are the one God is speaking to? Let me hear your loudest amen. You believe this blessing is changing your position? Let me hear your loudest amen. You believe this blessing is terminating your travails? Let me hear your loudest amen. You believe that your story is changing today? Let me hear your loudest amen. Asset in us walk with God is the blessing. Everybody prevails with blessings. People only travail without blessings. Everyone prevails with blessings. People only travail without blessings. Your travail must end today. For the blessings of the Lord it maketh rich, and it hath no sorrow with it. Your travails must end here today. But what are the virtues and blessings? It is blessing that empowers men to live a struggle-free life. Come and say, struggle-free life. Don't ever think that everybody is struggling. That's a lie of the devil. Not everybody is struggling. I know from scripture that sweat is a curse. As of the sweat of thy brow shalt thou eat bread all the days of your life. It's a curse. And Christ has redeemed us from the curse, which includes he has redeemed us from a life of struggles. For the blessings of the Lord make a rich, and that without struggles. That without struggles. Therefore, everyone struggle for survival, struggle to have ends met by the blessings of the Lord today. Proverbs 10:22, your struggles are turned into miracles.
Amen.
It's one thing for people to hear your testimony, it's another thing for them to see it. By this blessing today, you won't need to say it before people will see it.
Amen.
Jesus came that you and I may have life and have it at its best. Have it at its best. Have it in a marvelous way. In an enviable dimension. That's the life that Jesus offers. Therefore, I decree an end to all your struggles in life. Men and brethren and sons of the prophet, sons and daughters of the prophet, I'm not struggling. I'm just flowing under strange blessings implanted in me by those sent to me from time to time. I said to God, there is nothing we have done this year that we didn't do before. What's the difference? Come and say blessing. 29th of November, the man Copeland stood up and began to proclaim the blessing last year. We enter into the year just flowing in blessings. There's nothing, no explanation. Just flowing in blessings. Just flowing in blessings. Beginning from this day, today is 24. Beginning, just like I'm putting back to you what happened 29th of November, you'll be noting today by this time next year as your turnaround day. Hear this. Except you choose to go, there is no one under the sound of my voice with this prophetic verdict who will not be alive and well this time next year. And anyone that says no dies in your place. Anyone that says no dies in your place. Anyone that says no dies in your place. You and your household, by this blessing, the arrow of death returns not to the sender. You and your household, by this blessing, the arrows of struggles returns not to the sender. In the name of Jesus. Please get seated. Why? One of the virtues and blessings is your indestructibility. You are just indestructible with implanted blessing. So receive the blessing. Receive the blessing. Receive the blessing. Number three, virtue and blessing as mentioned earlier, Joseph was hated. His brothers wanted him dead. They programmed his death. But the Bible said, the blessings of thy father has prevailed, has brought them under. All the forces wherever they are gathered that hate to see you fulfill destiny, their evil thoughts towards you returns on their head sevenfold. Others may travail to get married, but today I declare your own prevailing. Others may travail to have children, but you have children without sweat. Other may survey to have a piano for their life, but you have clarity for every step of your life. Others may travail in business, you will prevail in business. Others may travail in their careers, you will prevail in your career. No one under the sound of my voice is permitted to bury his children. Understand, no one can bless himself. It's a mystery. You never hear in scriptures, I bless myself. No one can bless himself. Blessings are channeled through others. And these others can be classified into three. One, God. Amen. In blessing, I'll bless you. Multiply, we'll multiply thy seed that is under the seashore. And your seed shall possess the gates of the enemy. God blessed Abraham. And his seed is still prevailing today. Tiny Israel is an unbeatable entity. Any day. By the blessings that's upon them. Genesis 22, verse 17 and 18. Because thou hast done this thing. So there are things to do to provoke his blessings. And you have not withheld thy son, thy only son from me. By myself I have sworn that in blessing I will bless you. In multiplying, I will multiply thy seed like the sand of the seashore. And your seed shall possess the gates of your enemies. Tiny Israel. Everybody is careful. Everybody is careful. That nation will handle the Arab world with ease. It dominates in the midst of the enemy by the blessing. From today, wherever you have been harassed, I see you beginning to dominate. Yeah. By the blessings of God. God said to Abraham, get there to thy country, to a land that I will show you, and I will dare make of thee a great nation, and I, God, will bless you. And my blessing will be secured, for I will bless him that blesses you, and him that causes you, I will cause. And in you shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Amen. And Jesus died to bring us into the same realm of blessings like Abraham. So, today by this blessing, God is turning you supernaturally to a global citizen. Nobody may be able to explain how you get there, including yourself, but you are getting there by the blessing. You are getting there by the blessing. One day, after responding to an instruction to sow a seed from the Lord, say with me, from the Lord. And after sowing that seed, the Lord said to me, and I heard him, like a man hears his friend, my son David, even if you don't want to be rich, it's too late. Emilobo, I heard it by myself. Not that somebody told me. I heard it with my ears. Friends. So getting angry with my blessing is a curse. You just be cursing to rags and tatters. Because it's not man-made, it's God-made. And when God makes a man, any attempt to make him, we destroy the individual. God said to me, my son, you have touched me. I have empowered you for wealth. Shota? So, at least I've heard from God once. God proclaiming, swearing a blessing on my life like he did to Abraham. You can't stop it. Copeland said, this man fears you, and according to your word, his seed shall be mighty upon her. The generation of the oppressed shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house, and his righteousness endureth forever. He said, the wicked shall see it and gnash with their teeth. He said, the desires of the wicked shall melt away. And you know, when you receive an implanted blessing, it sticks. People proclaim blessings on me while my eyes are closed, but my heart is open. And I could recount statement by statement with comma and semicolon what they said. That's implanted blessing. The one that you can't even remember before you get to the gate. I didn't cram it, but I can recite 80 to 90% of all that he said. Yet I was on my knees. Talk to me. Implanted blessings. Let me hear you say implanted blessings. That is what makes all the difference. One of the months this year were 89,000 about the same month last year. Come on now. Implanted blessings. Don't get angry with the blessed. It's a curse. Because you get angry with just dying, just cheap death, and you are gone. Just be happy with him, even when you don't feel like be happy. God has blessed your neighbor with a baby, you are angry, you may never have one. By the blessing of today, anything to the contrary returns on the head of the individual. God blesses. The man Jabez prayed, and the Lord granted him that which he requested. He proclaimed a blessing and changed his story. 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9 to 10. Number 2, we discover that prophets bless. We remember that Aaron is a prophet and Moses was the apostle. If you put that picture together, can I hear your amen? And the Lord said to Moses, speak to the children of Aaron, speak to Aaron and his children, that after this manner shall they bless the children of Israel. Numbers chapter 6, verse 21 to 23. Or down from 23 to 27 or 26. Speak to Aaron that after this manner shall they bless the children of Israel. And from verse 23, he began to proclaim the blessings. So it is the responsibility or one of the key functions of priests to bless. To do what? Numbers 23 and verse 20. He said, the Lord has given me commandment to bless. Numbers 23, verse 20. Please don't be asleep. And he has blessed, and I cannot reverse it. That was Balaam speaking, the prophet. The Lord has given me commandment to bless. And because I proclaimed the blessing, God has sealed it. So we have blessings direct from God. We have blessings from prophets. Blessings from prophets. And then we have blessings from parents. We saw Isaac proclaim the blessings on Jacob. I have blessed him, and yea, he shall be blessed. Yea, It shall be blessed. My prayer today is that the blessings of today will stick to your life forever. This is a very interesting picture here. It's the blessings of Jacob that prevailed in the life of Joseph. It is the blessings of Isaac that caused Jacob to prevail in spite of all his challenges in life. Can I hear your amen? Now, here is the balance. When prophets stand in the name of the Lord and implant a blessing, they have committed God to confirm it. Can I hear your amen? Now, prophets are also reckoned with as fathers. As what? You remember what the king said? My father, shall I smite him? 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 21. My father, shall I smite him? So prophets are also fathers. So they stand in between. When they speak, God responds. When they speak, they are reckoned with as fathers. Glory to God. So you can connect with the blessings of God the Father, connect with the blessings of parents through one source. They say, my father has died. No, your father has not died. As long as you have a prophet sent to you, you have a father. Therefore, whatever blessing you didn't connect from your earthly parents, perhaps you have gone, I command every such blessing restored back on your head today. This is your day. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. The following blessings are to be expected to flow from your praises among others. One, say with me, divine favor. Every air of misfortune around anyone's life here is converted to favor. Because divine presence is a carrier of divine favor. And God inhabits the praise of his people. So when you are in praise, you enjoy divine presence, which naturally engenders divine favor. God was with Joseph and gave him favor as a slave. He was with him in the prison and gave him favor as a prisoner. God's presence guarantees the flow of favor. Therefore, I decree by your high praises this great man, that every air of misfortune in your life be turned into favor. Therefore, you are leaving this room with the smell of favor all over your body. Wherever your name is mentioned, favor will flow. Amazing things, supernatural harvest, a return for all your spiritual labor, your physical labor, your material labor. Everyone in this church has served at one level or another since the year began. You have gone out winning souls, you have gone out praying for souls to be saved, praying for souls to be established. You have gone out sweeping all night and working all day and serving in the satellite fellowship system. Every of your labor this year, I declare supernatural return before Shiloh arrives. Deliver us from all forms of bandages and captivities. There was a man by name Saul. Evil spirit came to disturb him, and every time David played on the harp, the evil spirit left him. High praises is a platform for supernatural deliverance. Therefore, whatever represents any bandage or imprisonment around anyone's life, right now, having gone through this meal of praise, I command instant deliverance in the name of Jesus. Amazing things. All barriers between you and your promised land, they are come down. There is judgment in the camp of your enemy right now. Supernatural breakthrough becomes your portion from today. Healings, miracles, signs, and wonders become your Lord. Whatever is called dead, forgotten, and stinking, there is restoration power in praise. So you are restored. And every prophetic word concerning you that is yet to be fulfilled between now and the 10th of December, 15 whole long days, I decree the turning of every of your captivity like a dream of the night. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Very quickly this morning, you are in this first service, and you are not born again yet, let me pray with you in a moment. Wherever you are, you want to give your life to Christ, because that's what entitles you to the blessings of the Father. Please stand to your feet very quickly, and I'll pray with you. God bless you. Everyone that wants to give his own life to Christ, please stand on your feet. There are also people here that need to rededicate their life to Christ. If you are there, you want to rededicate your life back to God, please stand to your feet also. I'll pray for the two groups together. God bless you. Maybe you are once saved, but somehow things went haywire. You know in yourself that you are disconnected and you want to reconnect back to God. Please stand. Everyone that wants to rededicate his life to Christ, please stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Amen. All of us who are standing in the first and the second call, please move to the nearest aisle to where you are standing. I'll be praying with you right there. Ushers, while we are doing that, would you make available to the people of God? Please remember, there is no Pre-Shiloh outreach this coming Saturday. It is the upper Saturday, which will be the last one for the year. Can I hear your amen? But you will go on your own personal reaching out to people around you. So the flyers for Shiloh, we have them available. Please make two copies available to everyone. And then the flyer for next Sunday, Pre-Shiloh Encounter Service, make that also available to everyone. Two copies, please. Two copies, please. While we are praying for these precious individuals, and then we will stay up in praise in this great service. All of us who are standing along the aisles, please. Complete your cards in a moment. We serve a very humorous God. This morning we have a publication here. We don't have enough copies yet, but we hope to have that before the day is over. Striking encounters with the God of liberation. There are testimonies that anchor on this prophetic platform. And like we had the testimony of that, my daughter today, God is in the midst of his people here. We don't have enough copies yet, but we will have that maybe, if not before the service is over, by midweek service, we'll have that together for everybody. We need you to get this and take full advantage of it. In Jesus' name. So please make available only the flyers, because the other ones are not going to go around. The flyers only, please. All of us who are standing, please bow your heads for prayers. If you have not completed your cards, you can complete that later on. Please bow your heads for prayers right now. All of us who are standing, and pray this prayer with me. Lift up your right hand before the Most High God, with your heads bowed, and pray this prayer with me from the depth of your heart. Say with me, Lord Jesus, I open my heart to you today. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Forgive me my sins. Wash me with your blood. I believe you died for me. On the third day you rose again, that I might be justified. Right now, I believe my sins are forgiven. I'm justified. I'm saved. I'm born again. I'm a child of God. Thank you, Jesus, for receiving me. Thank you, Jesus, for restoring me. And thank you, Jesus, for accepting me. Amen. Now be blessed in the name of Jesus. And I pray that the same grace that brought you for today will establish you forever. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Please, we have Believers Foundation classes holding on Mondays. And you are just required to attend for 2 Mondays and then you are through. Please, you find the location directory right there in your packet. 2 city locations across Lagos and Otter. There must be one closer to where you live, and endeavor to be there tomorrow. Jesus is Lord. Somebody excited here? Amen. Shall we get up on our feet? Glory to God. The blessing is speaking already. The blessing is speaking already. If that is so for your life, let me hear your loudest amen. Lift up your two hands and receive that garment of praise on your life as you praise God in a moment. Quiet, you are ready. Please come on the stand, my friend. Jesus, let my praise be acceptable to you today. Jesus, give me a turnaround experience in this high place for these few minutes. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name. In Jesus' precious name. In Jesus' precious name. Somebody shared this testimony. Ada Obiligwe. 1 minute in the bishop said, if you are in this service believing God for your life partner, stop asking God for your life partner. Begin to praise Him. I said it. I wrote it down in my note. And as he sang, I sang and praised God too. I thank God for my miracle marriage from that service till I got home. That same month. Come and say, that same month. He said, my husband came from Gabon. On February 23, 2013, I was covenantly married. Everything taken care of. Something must happen to someone died here. Somebody had a very disturbing growth for 40 years. But he came to the Hosanna service, and as was declared that we should dance and praise God, every unwanted growth on our bodies will melt away. It hit me. As the praise session was going on, I started dancing, and I had the auto check out on the growth, but I didn't see it again. It vanished instantly. I thank God for healing me. Abigail J. Certain things will happen within the few minutes that we have right now. Receive your turnaround encounter in this prayer.
We are saying thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jehovah, thank you. Everybody saying thank you, Jesus, thank you, thank you, Lord. We are saying thank you,
we are saying thank you,
Jesus,
thank you,
Jehovah,
thank you.
Thank you.
Everything is returning to you several folds back. in the name of Jesus. Today marks the end of your financial struggles. It marks the end of struggles in your career. It marks the end of struggles in your businesses. It becomes the end to all the struggles in your destiny. I declare every marital spell broken, every spell of barrenness broken, every spell of divorce and separation broken, in the name of Jesus. And finally, every force that is contrary to this blessing comes under a curse today. Every agent of the devil that is after your destiny for evil comes under a curse today. Everyone that won't want to see you live dies your death today. Everyone that won't want to see your children live dies their death today. In the name of Jesus. Together, lift up your hands, give God thanks for having showered these blessings on your life. And now let's share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship, everybody. Surely.